story of the Great War of Rikki Tikki Tavi, a mongoose who fought a pair of cobra throughout the rooms and garden of a big bungalow in India.
When Rikki Tikki was very young, a flood washed him out of his burrow and carried him down a ditch into the middle of a garden.
Look, Mother, there's a dead mongoose.
Perhaps he isn't really dead, Teddy. Let's dry him off.
He's not dead, just half choked. Now don't frighten him. We'll take him inside and see what he'll do once he's warmed up a bit.
Soon Rikki was himself again, and like all mongooses, he was eaten up with curiosity.
The mongoose motto is run and find out. So within moments, Rikki had run around the entire room, and then he jumped on the boy's shoulder.
Don't be frightened, Teddy. That's how he makes friends.
He's tickling me!
Good gracious, he's a wild creature. I suppose he's only tamed because we've been kind to him.
Every mongoose is like that. As long as Teddy doesn't pick him up by the tail, he'll run in and out of the house all day long.
There is much to find out about this family. I shall certainly stay and find out.
Rikki spent all that day roaming the house.
And when Teddy went to bed, Rikki Tikki climbed up too.
I don't like that. He might bite a child.
He'll do no such thing. Having a mongoose around is the surest way to protect against deadly snakes. Why, if one came to the room right now...
I don't want to think of such a thing. That's the one thing I don't like about India.
And she was right, because a cobra inside the garden walls brings danger and death.
Next morning, Rikki met Darzi the songbird, sitting on the edge of his nest, crying softly.
What is the matter?
Yesterday, one of our babies fell out of a nest, and Nag ate him.
That is terrible. Who is Nag?
Who is Nag? I am Nag. Look and be afraid.
Up from the brush came a huge cobra, spreading its massive hood.
Rikki knew a cobra's business is death.
But a mongoose can't stay frightened for long. Rikki knew a mongoose's business is to fight snakes.
Well, cobra or no cobra, do you think it is right for you to eat baby birds?
Nag watched the grass behind Rikki, hoping to catch Rikki off his guard.
Let us talk. You eat eggs. Why shouldn't I eat birds?
Behind you! Look behind you!
Rikki jumped up in the air as the head of Nagina, Nag's terrible wife, whizzed past him below.
Wicked, wicked birds!
Rikki's eyes grew red and hot. He sat back on his tail and hind legs and chattered with rage.
But Nag and Nagina disappeared into the grass.
That night, Rikki went out in the dark and bumped into Chandra the muskrat.
Please don't hurt me, Rikki Tikki.
Why would a snake hunter hurt a muskrat?
How am I to be sure some dark night Nag won't mistake me for you?
I will take care of Nag.
But those who kill snakes get killed by snakes. Then what? Nag is everywhere, Rikki Tikki.
What do you mean by that?
I mustn't tell you anything. Can't you hear, Rikki Tikki?
That is Nag and Nagina crawling into one of the bathrooms.
Rikki listened. He could just catch the faintest scratch of a snake on brickwork.
Rikki went off to the bathroom in the bungalow.
At the bottom of the wall, there was a brick pulled out for the pipes. Rikki listened. On the other side, Nag and Nagina were whispering.
Go in quietly. Remember, the big man is the first one to bite. Then we will hunt for Rikki Tikki together.
Are you sure there is any good in attacking the humans?
When the people are gone, Rikki Tikki will have to go away. And then the garden will be ours to rule. And when the eggs hatch, our young snakes will make room and quiet.
Rikki tingled with rage.
If I strike here, Nagina will know. But if I strike in the open, the odds will be in his favor. What am I to do?
Nag waved to and fro, and then Rikki heard him drinking from a big water jar that was used to fill the bath.
Ah, that is good. I'll wait here until the morning when the big man comes. Do you hear that, Nagina? I will wait here in the cool till daytime. Then I will strike.
There was no answer from outside, so Ricky knew Nagina had gone away.
Nag hid by the water jar, but Ricky stayed still. After an hour, he began to move muscle by muscle toward the jar.
At last, Nag is asleep. I must aim for the head and not let go. Oh, Ricky!
At the hold where he went in, Red Eye called to Wrinkle Skin. Hear what little Red Eye saith. Nag, come up and dance with death.
Ricky jumped, he bit and held on. He was battered to and fro as a rat is shaken by a dog, but he didn't let go.
The noise of Ricky being thrown about the bathroom woke the family. The big man came in ready to fight, but Nag was already dead.
It's the mongoose again, Alice. The little chump has saved our lives now.
I must get some rest if I am settled with Nagina. She will be worse than five nags, and there's no telling when her eggs will hatch.
In the morning, news of Nag's death was all over the garden. Darzee chirped a song of triumph at the top of his voice.
Who hath delivered us who? Tell me his master's name. Ricky the valiant and true. Ricky with eyeballs of flame.
You silly tuft of feathers, this is no time to sing.
Give him the thanks of the birds. Bowing the tail feathers spread. Praise him with nightingale words. Nay, I will praise him instead.
Are you listening to me, Darzee?
Nag is dead. He will never eat our babies again.
Yes, but what about Nagina?
Nagina called for Nag, and the big man tossed him onto the rubbish pile. Now let's sing for the red-eyed Ricky Dicky.
Stop singing this minute, Darzee. You are safe enough up there in your nest, but it's war for me down here.
For the great Ricky Tikki, I will stop.
Okay, now fly off to the stables and distract Nagina. Pretend that you have a broken wing. I need to get to the melon bed.
Darzee was a feathered-brained fellow, but his wife knew that cobra's eggs meant young cobras later on, so she flew off to trick Nagina.
When Dizar found Nagina, she fluttered in front of the snake and cried out,
my wing is broken! The boy from the house has stolen me and broken!"
Then she fluttered more desperately than ever.
You warned Ricky Tikki when I was about to strike. Now, you have chosen the wrong time to be laying.
He broke it with a stone.
Before night, the boy will lie very still. What's the use of running away when I'm sure to catch you? Oh, little fool, look at me.
Darzee's wife knew better, for a bird who looks at a snake's eyes gets so frightened that she cannot move.
Dizar fluttered along the ground, piping sorrowfully, and the snake quickened her pace.
Once Ricky heard them going up the path, she raced to find Nagina's eggs.
I'm not a day too soon. The minute these hatch, they could each kill a man or a mongoose.
A few minutes later, he heard Dizar screaming.
Come quickly, Ricky Tikki! I let Nagina down the path, and she has gone into the bungalow, and oh, come quickly! She means to attack!
Ricky took the last egg in his mouth and scuttled to the house. Inside the bungalow, the family was just gathering for breakfast.
Mother, what are we having for today? Something delightful, I hope.
Isn't everything delightful after the scare with the cobra?
Tinny, don't move!
What is it?
There's another cobra. It's under Tinny's chair. Whatever you do, Tinny, do not move.
Yes. Do not move, son of the big man who killed Nag. If you move, I strike. If you do not move, I strike. Oh, foolish people who killed my Nag.
It was then that Ricky entered the room.
Turn around, Nagina. Turn and fight.
All in good time. I will settle my account with you later.
Look at your eggs in the melon bed. Turn and look, Nagina.
The big snake turned half around and saw the one egg that Ricky had brought with him.
Give it to me!
His father shot a big hand caught Kitty by the shoulder and dragging him from the table out of reach of Nightingale.
Tripped, tripped, tripped. The boy is safe now, and it was I who caught Nag by the hood in the bathroom last night.
Then he began the jump, all 4 feet together, his head close to the floor.
It was all over before the big man even came.
Give me the last of my eggs and I will go away.
Yes, you will go away and you will never come back.
Eye to eye and head to head. This shall end when one is dead. Turn for turn and twist for twist. Ha, the hooded death has missed.
Ricky Chicky was staying out of reach of Nagina's fist bite. His little eyes red hot cold.
Again and again, Nagina struck, each time coming within a whisker of Ricky.
The egg still lay on the floor, till at last Nagina snatched it in her mouth and flew like an arrow down a path with Ricky Tikki right behind her.
There, Father! The snake has gone into that hole, and Ricky clenched onto the back of her tail and went down with her.
We can only hope he survives. Very few monkeys care to follow a snake down into its hole. In the dark, they never know when it might open up and let the snake turn and strike.
Oh, how very awful.
The family watched and listened, but for a long time, all was silent down the hole.
Nagina had surely killed him.
Darcy cleared his throat and bowed his head, when suddenly the grass by the hole quivered.
There he is, our Ricky at last!
Why, hooray, our mongoose has done it again.
It is all over. Nagina will never come out again.
This set everyone in the garden singing.
Give him the thanks of the birds, bowing with tail feathers spread. Praise him with nightingale words. Nay, I will praise him instead.
Ricky Tikki had all right to be proud of himself, but he did not grow too proud.
And he kept the garden as a mongoose should keep it, with tooth and jumping and spring a bit, till never a cobra dared to show its head inside the walls.
Who hath delivered us who? Tell me his nest and his name. Ricky the valiant, the true. Tikki with eyeballs aflame.
Why shouldn't I did it wrong.